Hello everyone, this is Ekta Takrani, your online social science teacher. So in this video, I am going to share question paper pattern for class 9th and 10th. As you are new here in this high school, you are not familiar with the new pattern which is introduced by CBSE for your different exams. So in this video, I am sharing the pattern for your pre-midterm, midterm and post-midterm exams. Okay, so let us go with the pattern of the question paper. Okay, so it will be very helpful to prepare for your exams. So we will start with the maximum marks. Okay, maximum marks here. We are taking maximum marks. That is 40. Okay, that will be your 40 marks paper. It can be 40, then midterm will be of 50 marks. So this is pre-midterm and post-midterm. 40 marks paper. The first section will contain one mark question. One mark questions will be there in your first section. Okay, one mark questions. That will be, we can say, 10 questions of one mark each. That is 10 marks. Okay, 10 questions of one mark each. So one mark, don't get confused that it will be only MCQs. No, there is a wide variety of questions that we will be asking in one mark questions. Okay, as per CBSE, there are different questions in one mark questions that I will be telling you in this video only. Next, we will go with the second section 2. Next section will be containing short answer type question. Okay, short answer type question. And the marks allotted are 3 marks to 4 questions. 4 questions, 3 marks each. So total it will be 12 marks. So this is section B, that is short answer type question, 3 marks question. So CBSE is expecting 3 different points. So as much as possible you write in points. Then the third section is about long answer type question. Long answers, as you were writing in your middle school also, you were having long answer type questions. So here they give more preference to points. So marking scheme is like 5 marks question will contain 5 points. So you will have 3 questions, 5 marks each. So that will be of 15 marks. 15 marks are given to long answer type question. These are 3 different sections. Then section 4 will contain map based question. Remember, map based question. So it will not be the same what you have done in the previous classes, that simply locate the place. No, it will be locate and identify. It can be identification also. Identify the place where the first Congress meeting took place. Then the question can be asked the place where Jallianwala Bagh massacre took place. Like this, you have to identify the place and then locate. Or it can be located already in the map, you have to identify. So it can be locate and identify, identify and locate, or simply name will be given and you will be asked to locate it. So this different variety of questions will be there in map based also. That will be 3 different questions of 1 mark each. So 3 marks are given to map based questions. So this total will be of 40 marks, that is the maximum marks. Now again we'll come to one mark question, which I told you is very important and it is different than your previous classes. Section A, one mark question. So it will not be only MCQs. What we believe, what we think MCQ is with 4 options. It can be multiple choice question. We call it multiple choice question. Okay, so multiple choice questions are, we believe multiple choice is that 4 options will be there. So that is not the only thing will be there in one mark question. There will be different types, like it can be this choose the correct option. Next, it can be true false. It can be give reason. You will get a statement and you have to give a reason for it. Then it can be a fill in the blank. Fill in the blank. You can get a fill in the blank, any one fill in the blank. Then very important and something new is there is assertion and reason based questions, right? Which is a new thing for you and this you have to understand. Assertion and reason based question. You will get a statement You will get a statement and you have to give your opinion that whether it is correct, the reason is correct, the assertion is correct or not. So I will show you one example for this. Along with this, you will get give one word also. Give one word, match the columns. All the variety of questions will be asked in section A. One mark type of question. It will not be only multiple choice. That is, choose the correct answer. It may contain true, false, give reason, fill in the blanks, assertion and reason based question, give one word, or the flow chart. You have to fill the answer in it, match the column. Any type of question will be asked. So I will show you the example here. This is again the sample papers shared by CBSE. And here I have got one question for you. You can see here, this is question number 15. Question number 15 says that in the given question, you have got two statements marked as assertion and reason. You have to read the statement and choose the correct option. The assertion, it's a belief that democracy is a legitimate government. Legitimate means acceptable. Acceptable by the people, acceptable by law. Democracy is a legitimate government. It is assertion, that is A. Reason, that is represented with R. Why? What is the reason for this? It regular, free and fair elections are the spirit of democracy. So this is assertion and this is reason. After reading this, you have to come to the conclusion that whether both A and R are true, and R is the correct explanation of A. Both A and R are incorrect. A is correct but B is incorrect. A is incorrect but B, R is correct. So like this, you have to choose A and R. Both are correct or both are incorrect, or one is correct, another is the correct reason. So you have to choose correct option. These are known as assertion and reason based question. So we can say these are application based question. After understanding the chapter, you have to apply the knowledge you have gained. One more example I will show you of this one mark type of questions. You can see here, complete the following table. Here the flow chart is given and the two blanks are given. That is a one mark. Means half mark is given to each answer. A and B are to fill. So yeah, these are the examples of different types of transport. That is land, water and air. So water, it can be inland and what? And here land, it has got roadways, railways are the example of land transport. So here pipeline will come. And like this, you will get many such examples. Complete the flow chart. So give reason, choose the correct answer, assertion and reason based question, match the column, and all these will be the part of your one mark type of question. It will be there in your pre-midterm, post-midterm or annual exams also. In all the exams it will come. Okay, and the map work I have already told you, it will be based on locate and identification. In with this video up to here, stay connected to know more about CBSE updates in the coming videos. Thank you.